Dr. Lynne.
So good to see you.
I hear that you had a really impressive sighting.
I was right in this area. I was home. This is before 7 o'clock, and it was dark. And I'm sitting in front of the TV. The lights started to flicker. And when those lights went out, then the TV went off. I saw huge balls of amber light, like nothing you've ever seen before. So I grabbed my camera, and I started photographing them.
Can I see the photos that you took?
Absolutely. First one, and then another pop-up, so there were four altogether.
Yeah, I see there's four.
The lights all appeared in a line, a formation, as if they were connected to a singular craft.
They were so unusual. Technology-wise, it seemed that there was an intelligence behind them. And I noticed an eerie silence, as if time had stopped. It felt like something was watching me.
Wow.
It was extraordinary.
Were you seeing any lights, like from aircraft in the area?
There were planes coming into the airport, Sky Harbor International Airport, at the same time.
So we compare this, which we know is a plane. Look how bright these are.
Quite different from any plane.
So you have video of this as well?
I do. This is a video.
Oh, wow.
The video also shows the bright lights in formation, hovering in place. They are too close to each other to be helicopters and too bright to be drones.
You got something really impressive, like just hovering out there.
Exactly.
But there's more. This is not the first time Dr. Kitei has seen UFOs in the Arizona skies. Almost 25 years ago, Dr. Kitei filmed what has become known as the Phoenix Lights.
I've been seeing these phenomena since March 13, 1997.
Among ufologists, the Phoenix Lights have become one of the most iconic UFO videos ever filmed. 20,000 citizens reported seeing the strange object pictured in Dr. Kitei's video. They described it as a mile-wide, triangle-shaped craft with six distinct lights. It crossed roughly 300 miles of airspace, with reports coming in from Phoenix to Tucson. And one of the witnesses turned out to be a famous actor.
One of the private pilots happened to be Kurt Russell.
I saw six lights over the airport in absolute uniform in a V shape, and I reported it. And they said, we're not painting anything, we don't show anything. I said, well, okay, I'm gonna declare it's unidentified, it's flying, and it's six objects.
That was the most viewed UFO event. Over 20,000 people saw that.
Thousands of people? What's going on?
It could possibly be, I think, the greatest mass sighting in our country's history. And you had a front row seat.
I did.
With so many witnesses to this event, the government was forced to investigate, bringing about what is believed to be one of the greatest UFO cover-ups in history. They claim the lights were not attached to an alien aircraft, but were simply flares set off during a military exercise.
When they had to come out with something, they came out with the flare theory. Flares drift haphazardly with the wind, have huge smoke trails. It was bizarre. The next morning, headlines.
That's really disappointing.
Phoenix lights are flares.
It's like they bit at hook, line, sinker and said, this is what the military says, this is what we're going with.
Exactly.
Military flares leave behind prominent smoke trails as they fall, which rules them out as a suspect. But others saw the static hovering lights. To find out about any other mass UFO sightings in American history, Ben is headed to the Center for UFO Studies to talk with historian Mark O'Connell.
So Ben, I have talked to so many witnesses who saw the Phoenix Lights. You know, it was 1997. There were thousands of people who saw the triangle. I talked to people who saw this thing as close as 30 feet above their head.
Oh.
None of it made sense. All I know for certain is I believe that there was the disinformation campaign. I'm baffled, and I want to know, is this type of thing have precedence? Has there been other cases where there's been a mass UFO sighting, and the government is so adeptly able to come in and just take over and silence them?
Let me show you a file that I've been looking at.
All right.
This is the official Michigan 66 flap.
swamp gas flap.
Dr. J. Allen Hynek was the lead scientific advisor to Project Blue Book, a government-funded investigation of the nation's UFO sightings from 1952 to 1969. According to Mark, in 1966, the Air Force sent Dr. Hynek to Dexter, Michigan, a small town outside of Ann Arbor. There, he investigated reports of a UFO seen by a farmer, Frank Manor, and his son, Ron.
There are a lot of parallels between the Phoenix Lights and the infamous Dexter, Michigan swamp gas sightings. Dozens of witnesses, the government getting involved in strange and misleading ways. So here's a recording of an interview with Frank Manor, who was one of the witnesses.
We were watching television, and we have six dogs here, and they started raising a fuss. I went outside on the porch. I looked to the north, and there looked like a falling star coming down. I looked at it, and I thought I was seeing things, and a blue and a white light come on it.
It becomes a huge, huge national headline, much like the Phoenix Lights did, right?
Yeah.
I mean, Air Force hates it when a UFO story becomes too big.
Yeah.
So what does the Air Force do? They send Hynek to Michigan. He interviews the Manor family. But get this, he's getting pressure from his boss to make this case go away quickly. Everybody wants Hynek to say, spaceships, little green men. And instead, he says, what these witnesses describe could have been swamp gas.
The official explanation, swamp gas, flares, caused by the burning of gases bubbling up from the area swamp.
The country's leading UFO expert just said everybody in Michigan is an idiot who can't tell swamp gas from a flying saucer. So that's kind of along the lines of Phoenix.
Right.
It was really the defining moment in Dr. Hynek's career.
So the government's gonna say it was swamp gas. Can we prove that it wasn't? There's a lot of witness testimony. I'd actually like to see if any of these people are still alive.
I was a young sheriff, the second youngest sheriff in the state of Michigan. At that time, there was one sighting after another in Dexter.
I understand you spent a lot of time with Dr. Hynek when he came into town.
I never heard of Professor Hynek. Didn't know who he was. Yeah. But I knew that, you know, it had to be somebody important. My curiosity got the best of me. And I said, Dr. Hynek, what have we got? And I remember him saying to me, I don't know. And I found that very strange, you know? When we got back to my office, he said, I got to call Washington. That stuck with me so much, I got to call Washington.
Okay.
He was in there for quite a while. And he came out, Professor, what do we got? What do we got? He said, it's swamp gas. I like to die. Swamp gas. You think about that for a minute. He had no idea, but then when he makes a call to Washington, all of a sudden, he comes out with, it's swamp gas.
How frustrating. Wow.
Yes, I was disgusted. What is swamp gas?
I've never seen it.
Yeah, insulting to anybody's intelligence. I think we could have come up with something better than that.
But there's more. Sheriff Harvey has never before revealed information, something that doesn't appear in any of Dr. Hynek's Project Blue Book reports. Hours before the news conference and Hynek's call to Washington, Sheriff Harvey and Dr. Hynek visited the swamp on Frank Manor's farm and found something.
And in the backfield, the grass was down in a, like a circle. It was matted down, you know, like something just laid on it.
That's not in any of the reports.
Is it possible that Hynek purposely left that out? He left out what you had seen with him, the depression.
I know that I seen it, and so did Hynek. He went up to it.
To Sheriff Harvey, the possibility that a UFO landed here is real.